An army of officers stationed outside the union headquarters where yesterday's violent scenes began. As police shuffled their strategy in response to a third consecutive day of protests.
I'd be very surprised if you see any cat and mouse games today.
A beefed up security force of more than 500 police officers moving in at rapid speeds, arresting protesters out on the streets who disregarded police warnings to stay at home.
Stop resisting! All right!
Authorities today leaving nothing to chance.
And they have my full support in deploying whatever tactics they need to ensure that these thugs, these violent thugs, are unable to cause further harm to our city.
As protesters continued demanding for the vaccine mandate issued to the construction industry to be lifted, Victoria's Premier remained firm as the state recorded 628 new virus cases.
Today, there are more coronavirus cases in construction than there are in aged care. There are more cases of coronavirus in the construction sector than there are patients with coronavirus in hospital.
By this afternoon, hundreds of police had circled Melbourne Shrine of Remembrance, where protests had spilled onto the steps of the war memorial.
The Australian flag held by some protesters at the top of one of the city's most sacred places. The use of the memorial hailed as disrespectful.
Generations of Australian servicemen and women have put their lives on the line to protect this nation. Any protest here takes away and diminishes the actions of our veterans.
Both police and the CFMEU says the protests have been hijacked by anti-vaxxers and extremist groups.
It's a political opportunity for extremists, so the long lockdown actually gives them more of an opportunity to exercise their influence, because people are trapped in a situation where they are not able really to intermingle with others. They're getting most of the information online.
Late this afternoon, police advanced on the protesters, firing non-lethal rounds to force them to disperse. They have vowed to protest every day that the construction industry is shut down. Hishayla Kumarawansa, SBS World News.